and in today's session we will learn about Planck quantum of action and external photoelectric effect. Order code is 21225093.1. Apparatus required for the experiments are.
So the first apparatus is LED power supply. This is the knob which is used to increase the intensity of LED bulb. Here we will connect the connecting cords from a LED light source. This is the light indicator and this is the toggle switch to turn and turn off. Then after that, this is DC regulated power supply of plus minus 5 volt. This is the toggle switch to take to positive 5 volt and negative 5 volt polarity. This is toggle switch for turn on and turn off. Here we will connect the connecting cords and this is band switch for voltage control. And after that, this is digital picometer. This digital picometer is basically used to measure the photoelectric current. And this is zero adjust knob and this is multiplier knob. And here we will connect the connecting cords and this is toggle switch to turn in and turn off. And now after that, this is the whole setup of optical bench. So in this optical bench setup, there are basically two ends. We have connected the two benches. So this is left end of the bench and that is right end of the bench. So now talking about the left side of the bench. So this is LED light source. We have to attach it to 14. Then after that, this is slit. We have to set it to 29 centimeter and this is the 100 mm lens. We have to set it to about 41 centimeter. Then at the mid of this optical bench, we have to set a grating which is of 600 line per mm grating into this grating holder and we have to attach it to the center of turning knuckle. And at the right side of optical bench, we have to set the iris diaphragm at about 25 centimeter. And then after that, we have to set the photo cell near about 46 centimeter. Then after that, we will do the connection. So we will make the connections for DC regulated power supply, digital picometer and the photo cell. So for that, first of all, we have to connect the output of DC power supply to the input of photo cell. Then after that, DC regulated power supply output to digital picometer. And then at last, we have to connect digital picometer to photo cell input. So this is the whole setup and all the connections for right hand side. Then after that, we have to make the connections for left hand side, which is of LED power supply. So for that, we have to connect these connecting cords to LED power supply. So now before proceeding to our experiment, first of all, we have to check the setup. So for that, we have to set the turning knuckle to 0 degrees. So as you can see that we have set it to 0 degrees. Then after that we have to set this paper. Then after that switch on the LED power supply. So as you can see that LED bulb starts glowing. So on white paper you can observe the rectangle and you can also see different color grating. So this means that our setup is proper. Now we will set it to different angles to get the different colors grating on photo cell. Then after that you have to move the right end of optical bench and set it to 16 degree. So you can see that 16 degree on turning knuckle. Then after that you have to switch on the digital picometer and through zero adjust set it to 0 ampere. Then after that switch on the DC regulated power supply. So now after making certain changes with lenses and iris diagram, you can observe that there is a rectangular violet color box. So this directly goes into your photocell, and after that we will increase the voltage to get the current. Then after that you have to increase the voltage. Simultaneously you also have to set the multiplier. Then increase the voltage. So as you can see that voltage is increasing. You have to take a point where the current becomes zero. So you have to note that voltage at which current becomes zero. So as you can see that at about near about 3.311 volt, it's about 3.11 volt, the current is about to be zero. So near about 3.2 or 3.1 volt, the current is zero. So this is the reading for violet color. So after that, when you will rotate the table right hand side, so you can observe the different color fringes. So it will be of green, yellow, orange, red. So you have to rotate the table at 19 degree, 21 degree, different degrees. So similar step is also for this. So you have to increase the voltage, and at that point, till that point when your digital picometer current becomes zero. So you can see for violet it's about 3.21, the current is zero. Then after that for green color, you have to rotate the table to 19 degrees. So now it's 11 degrees. So you have to rotate it to 19 degrees, near about 19 degrees. So it's 19 degrees for green color. So now you can observe a green rectangle on white paper. So this means that it enters to our photocell. Now we will note the reading. So now after that you have to increase the voltage. So as you can see that as I am increasing the voltage, so current is also increasing. So now after increasing the voltage and setting the multiplier, you can observe that at 2.85 volt the current is zero. So for green light this voltage is 2.85. So as you can see that we have measured the bias voltage for zero current for different angle in the first order diffraction spectrum of the lamp for 600 lines per mm grating. So we have measured for violet color, which is 16 degree, and for green color, which is 19 degree. You can repeat the procedure for red, orange and yellow color also by rotating the table left right hand side. Then after that you have to calculate the light frequency, which is corresponding to your spectrometer angle, where alpha is the spectrometer angle, d is the constant of grating, where it is defined as 1/600, lambda is the wavelength of emitted light, and the order of diffraction is 1 in this case. So c is equal to speed of light. So the frequency, the formula for light frequency, f is equal to c by lambda. So now in our next experiment, we will determine the stopping voltage V experimentally for different light frequencies and plot it over the light frequency and calculate Planck's constant from the dependence of stopping voltage on the light frequency. So first of all, you have to set the turning knuckle to 16 degree. So after that you have to switch on the setup as we have done in our previous experiment also. So you can observe a rectangle, blue color rectangle, violet color rectangle on the white paper. So it will goes, the light will enter to our photocell. Now we have to make certain changes on our apparatus part. So now after observing one wavelength on our photocell, now we will increase the voltage to near about 4 to 5 volt and set the negative polarity. So we will increase the voltage. So as you can see that as I am increasing the voltage, so current is also increasing.
So as you can see, as I am increasing the voltage, current is also increasing. So we have to set the voltage to near about 4 to 5 volt. So you have to slowly do this process. So as you can see, we will set it to near about 4.29 volt. So after that, you have to switch the polarity to plus 5 volt. So you will see that the current will change. Now after that, we have to deaccelerate the voltage. So I'll decrease the voltage. You can see that as I am decreasing the voltage, so current is also decreasing. So we have to take the voltage where current becomes zero. So you can constantly see that our current is also decreasing. So you can see that at 0.76 volt, our current becomes zero. So for violet wavelength, voltage is 0.76. Now after that, we have set the angle to 19 degree. So now as you can observe the green wavelength on photocell. Then after that, we have to set the voltage to in the range between 4 to 5 volt and set it to plus 5 volt polarity. Now you have to increase the voltage. According to that, you also have to set the multiplier. So as you can see that we have set the voltage to 4.41 volt. Now we will switch the polarity to minus 5 volt. So as you will, then you will observe the current on this. So now after that, we will deaccelerate the voltage. So as you can see, as the voltage is decreasing, then current is also decreasing. Now we have to find the voltage at which current becomes zero. Slowly you have to decrease the voltage. So you can see that at 0.61 volt, current becomes zero. So now after that, we have to make the table for angle, wavelength, stopping voltage value. So at 16 degree, wavelength is 475 and voltage is 0.76 volt. And this wavelength is in nanometer. So we have taken the all reading, more readings. This is for 16, 19, 21, 27.5, 29 degree. 16 is for violet wavelength, 19 is for green wavelength, 21 is for yellow wavelength, 27.5 is for orange wavelength, and 29 is for red wavelength. So these are its corresponding stopping voltage value. So as you can see that as the degree angle is increasing, then voltage is decreasing. So from violet to red, the voltage is decreasing. And you can observe on the graph paper, as the frequency is increasing, then stopping potential is also increasing. So its del Vs is approx 0.91 and del V is approx 2.2. So now we will calculate its Planck constant. Then after that, by this formula of Planck constant, we have to put the values, and you can see that the value is 6.26 into 10 raised to the power minus 34. This is approximately equals to our standard value of Planck. And you have to make one more table, which is of photocurrent and biased voltage. So as we have observed in our experiment, as we are increasing the biased voltage, then photocurrent is also increasing, and vice versa is also true for this.
Hence, this is all about today's session. For further query, you can contact Tesla Technologies Private Limited, and you can also refer to our user manual. So thank you for watching the video.